We got episode 40. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I just joined the gym. I don't know if that's obvious in this episode, but today we're going to be talking about names. Interesting, weird, obscure adult names. Christian names, God-given names. Although I don't know why they say, well, why do people say that? They say, oh, it's my God-given name, because your parents named you. But I guess God, you know, created language and letters, so you got to give him some respect there. But your birth name, okay? I thought about this because with my new job, I come across a lot of names just in our system. You know, I see a lot of names throughout the day. And I can't help but see the funny ones. You know, you see a million Johns and Michaels and Sarahs and Ethans and Jose's and what else? You see a lot of Rebecca's, the occasional Raymond, but the ones that stick out are the silly ones. And today we want to talk about silly names. And so in doing that, I started making a list of strange names just kind of for fun to make my job less boring. And then I was like, oh, this might be funny to ask people what are some weird names they've come across. And so I decided to not do any like famous names, but just people that I've met, names I've seen in, you know, writing or heard about, but you know, not like Meta World Peace or Prince or the symbol that the artist formerly known as Prince. I'm talking about real people that have normal jobs, normal lives, but for some reason, their parents had the audacity to name them something like this. So I did an Instagram question. This was months ago. I meant to do this episode a while ago, but hey, I've been busy. Not that busy, but I told you I joined the freaking gym. So I've been really, you know, when you're throwing around a lot of weight like I am, like you just can't be doing episodes that often. But I'm starting to find the balance. So hopefully we'll get back in the swing of things. But so a lot of people answered this and gave me some amazing names. And as you know, if you're from Utah or you've spent any time in our state, for some reason, the Utah folk, we like to get real creative with our like white names and our spelling of white names, and then just adding these little like, I don't know, these little name suffixes. Like you'll get like an Ashlyn, which I don't think you hear much outside of Utah. I'm sure they exist, but you don't hear a lot of Ashlyn. And then you'll get like an Ashlinsley, or like a instead of, like, I've heard Lakin a few times, but what was it? There was like a Lakesley or Lakenly. Like they just throw letters on the end haphazardly. They don't care. They just want to be unique and cute, but some of these kids gotta live with these names, parents. So if you're listening and you're thinking of naming your child something, listen, I've thought about this myself. I want my kids to have unique names. But you don't want them to be so unique that everyone makes fun of them for their ridiculous name, right? And you know, there's nothing wrong with a sturdy, you know, just naming your son Paul or frickin', you know, Leroy. You know, maybe hit him with a Sammy. But you know, there's nothing wrong with that. But you know, that's the safe way to go. You know, it's hard to make fun of your your kid if his name's David, you know? Unless his last name's David. Don't name your son David David. Okay, let's start. The first one somebody sent in, not that original as far as weird names go. It's Pepper Sage. Now, Pepper's an interesting name because you got to think somebody's just going to start calling him Pep or Peppy or Pepperoni. It's not a terrible name. It just, to me, you sound like a horse. Like, I know lots of horses named Pepper. I'm sure there's some dogs out there named Pepper too. So it gets a little tricky when your name sounds like it belongs a little bit more to an animal. But I don't hate it either. Pepper Sage. I'll tell you what name I like. I like Piper. I don't know why. I really like Piper. There was this cutie in my middle school named Piper. And she always wore those chokers, you know? And she wore chokers and big Skechers, real big Skechers. You know, probably add 3 or 4 inches. And I don't think she shampooed her hair very often, but she was cute. Sweet Piper. Okay, the next name. This is cruel. Okay, a lot of these people sent in, and these are amazing. And everyone that somebody sent in, I messaged them and was like, are you serious? Is this for real? Like, how do you know this person? Just so they weren't, like, making stuff up, right? This person knew somebody named Nancy Ann Cyancy. So their last name is Cyancy, and their parents had the audacity to name them Nancy. Nancy Ann Cyancy. Nancy Cyancy. That's just, I'm hoping it was like an aunt or an old lady, because it's mean to name your daughter Nancy, I think after like 1998. But wow, Nancy Cyancy. Just imagine. Next we have somebody, their first name, I didn't get last names on all these because sometimes last names they're not the interesting part, but sometimes they are. This person's first name is Fleahona. Okay, Fleahona. Now again, if you are somewhat versed in Mormon culture, you are probably familiar with the name Leahona. So I'm assuming this is a spin on Leahona, and just putting some in there, some Fleahona. That's wild. Again, I wouldn't advise to start a name with flea anything, you know, Fleabert or Fleason or Flicky. It's not the way to start. Fleahona, everybody. The next one is, now this is where things get controversial. Now, I could go into the history of why they do this, which is kind of interesting, but as I'm sure you've ran across, there are people in the Hispanic community, Latin American community, with the name Jesus, right? And they tend to, you know, go by Jesus. But it's ballsy, man, to name your son Jesus. You're setting him up for failure. It's like naming your son Zeus or Michael Jordan, you know? At least Michael B. Jordan had the, you know, presence of mind to just throw in a B so everyone didn't think he was Michael Jordan. Anyways, this person's name is Jesus Barriga. Jesus Barriga, which translates to Jesus tummy or Jesus stomach in Spanish. And again, I don't know if Barriga is a common surname in Hispanic culture, but that name is hilarious to me. In Portuguese, it would be Jesus Bahiga. Anyways, this next one on the similar lines. This is a last name I don't think I've ever come across. I'm sure I've read it or heard about it, but this person's name is Janine, which I don't hate Janine. Again, kind of an older name, kind of a classic name. Janine Christ. Like, oh man. It's just wild that that name has lasted the test of time. Because so many names get changed, you know, after generations and generations of this or that, or, you know, you move to America, or you anglicize a name and it changes a little bit. But Janine Christ, that's, again, you know, are you going to name your son God? It's crazy, but I kind of like it. Janine Christ. I almost feel uncomfortable saying it, you know. I might just go by JC. Now we're taking a hard left turn. Hard left. This person, their last name is Fuchs. This one I've seen several times. I first came across it in third grade. We had a substitute teacher who was, whatever, Mr. Fuchs. And to this day, I think that's how he pronounced it. I can only assume it's Fuchs, because I'm not going to say John, first name John here. I'm not going to say John Fuchs. I'm just not going to do it. It feels disrespectful. But listen, if your last name is Fuchs, change it. All right? It's time. You've made your point. You're resilient, but just, it's time to change it. Okay? This next name, I don't know if it's funny or sad or cool. It's Loney Stone. Loney Stone. Now, I kind of like the name Loney, but to me, it's a little too close to lonely. You got to think that's going to give him a bit of a complex. It would for me. I already have my bouts with loneliness. I don't need my name reminding me every day. Hey, Loney. Why are you so lonely? Loney Stone. This is a classic. Harry Chang. I'm pretty sure I've met a Harry Wang. I feel like he was that hibachi master, but I could be wrong. This is a name I came across at work. Before I attempt to pronunciate it, I will tell you how it's spelled. It is spelled Y-S-H-M-Y-J-A-H. Okay, that's Y-S-H-M-Y-J-A-H. So my assumption is that it is Yishmiyaja. Yishmiyaja. Shmiyaja. Again, I'm sure this is, gosh, I don't know, Bangladeshi or Indian or Pakistani or Sri Lankan. I really have no idea. Obviously, it's a transliteration of name in a different language, a different alphabet. Because, you know, you're not born in America with American parents and say, oh, let's name our son Ishmael Jaha. Because that's gonna be tricky in school. But again, I'm gonna change that. If I come to America and my name is Yishmiyah Shah, I gotta change it, because, or I gotta go by Yoshi or Ja or something. And maybe they do, right? Maybe this is just the legal name that I saw, but it was wild. This next name, kind of special to me. This was a kid I went to middle school with. His name was Johnson Daniel. Now, I'm always a little weirded out when someone has like two last names or two first names. Two last names, I think, is worse. But this one, in case you didn't know, it's not used a ton anymore. I think it was more in like the 90s or whatever, but the word Johnson is synonymous for a certain male organ in the southern hemisphere of a male body. And so, you know, I understand if it's your last name, you might get a little heat from the guys. But as a first name, Johnson, that's tough. Especially when your last name is a first name, Daniel. Johnson Daniel. He was a good kid. He's one of those kids that, man, I don't know what happened to him. I don't know if he invented like a new element, or if he died when he was 16, or if he got like a mail order bride from the Ukraine. I don't know. He's off the grid, and I haven't seen him since the end of eighth grade. So, Johnson Daniel, if you're listening, I love you, buddy. Okay, this ain't right. So, my sister teaches high school English, and so she commented and said she had a student, first name Paige, okay, last name Turner, the third. Okay, so that means not only did somebody think they were cute and say, oh, our last name is Turner, let's name our son Paige, that'll be great, or could be a daughter, it happened three times. That's just, I need to meet this family because they got issues. Okay. This next one, probably one of the weirdest names I've ever dated. Okay. This girl's first name, not a nickname, not a name she changed when she was 21. Her name is Lullaby, which is kind of cool. The only thing I didn't like about it was I felt like it was really hard to like shorten, like, I couldn't call her Lull. Like, Lull didn't feel right. And maybe some people call her Lull, but I don't like names that you can't abbreviate. I felt like that one was tough to abbreviate. But what's crazy is her little sister's name is Love Story. Okay? It's not her first name Love and her middle name Story. Her first name is Love Story. Cool. Cool, guys. And you know, maybe that is kind of cool. I don't know. You know, people call you Love, or people call you Lovey, or Story. I'd be like, no, call me Story. Call me Historia. That's what I want. That's just crazy. Like, I thought Lullaby was wild, and then she's like, yeah, my sister's Love Story. I was like, dang. Love Story. Anyways, speaking of love stories, I really liked Lullaby. But she was super young and ultimately told me to go sit on a bag of rocks. But she's a cool girl. This is kind of crazy. I went to middle school in Phoenix, Arizona. And it wasn't a rough part of town, but it was rough adjacent. So our school had some ruffians. Our school had some hood children. And I had some homies that I used to wait for the bus with, right? So they're all kind of neighborhood kids. And we all would just wait for the bus together and we'd cause mayhem. And two of these kids one day, because we're in Phoenix, got a bunch of cactus and lined it in the middle of the road all the way across. So cars would get flat tires. And we did that. And gosh, I don't even remember what happened. I feel like, gosh, what happened? I don't know. I didn't get in trouble though. I was just chilling. I was watching. But these kids would cause problems almost every day. But there was a black kid and a white kid, both cool freaking kids. I think they're both a grade older than me. And what's crazy is the black kid was named Ashton Walker, and the white kid was named Ashton Walker. No relation. And they were both like just crazy kids that were down to do anything for a laugh or anything for like a little bit of attention. One of these Ashtons, the white one, we were on the bus one day and he threw a rock out the window at a windshield, at like a car that was like going like 10 miles an hour. Just hucked it, started laughing, and we drove off. He also threw bologna at windshields because he thought it was funny how it would just stick to the windshield. Black Ashton eventually went to jail. I'm not sure what for. It was after my time. But I just thought it was crazy. Two kind of similar, you know, young hoodlums, both named Ashton Walker, no relation, different race. It's crazy. Let's see. Somebody, this is the first name is Dusty, which I've heard before. You know, it's usually short for Dustin, I assume. But this was a woman's name. Dusty is a woman. I'm thinking I'm changing that. this next name is Trampus Rodell. Trampus. I don't even know if this was a boy or a girl, but neither, it doesn't matter. It's bad. Don't name your kid Trampus or Trumpus. It has to be Trampus. That's bad. Change it. This next one is Rip, R-Y-P. Now, this is funny because I have a buddy named Ryan Peterson, and we've called him Rip over the years, just kind of that R-Y from Ryan and the P from Peterson, so we call him Rip, and that's like his, you know, his social media handle and stuff, is like Rip Skip or whatever. So he goes by Rip sometimes, but this is an actual name, and it is a female name, just Rip. R-Y-P, Rip. Not sure what we're thinking there, guys. This one, when I heard this, I was like, no, this, no parent would do this. This is like a joke. This is like something you read on BuzzFeed, like worst names of all time. But again, this was my sister who's a teacher who had a student. First name, Mo. Last name, Lester. Molester. Molester. You have to change it or you're automatically on the sex offender list. You have no choice. So change it. Change it, Mo. If you're listening, you're either in jail and somebody somehow got this podcast to you. And thank you for listening, by the way. Or you changed it and you don't go by Mo anymore. Those are the only two options. There's no way a Mo Lester is just walking around, has a normal job, isn't getting beat up every day, isn't in prison. There's no way. Gosh, these are wild. And they're honestly, they're hard to believe. But like I said, I tried to vet these the best I could. Oh man, I had some chicken nuggets tonight from McDonald's. Which, you know, it's a polarizing item. You know, you either love them or hate them. But my roommate thinks that they are 3D printed. They're starting to feel like maybe they were. Okay, this next person, their name is Firoz Butts. Firoz is F-I-R-O-Z-E. I might be pronouncing wrong. Firoz. Butts. Again, the last name Butts, it's not great. I also know somebody with the last name B-U-T-Z, which is kind of better. It feels a little like Germanic. Thoreau's Butts. If your last name's Butts, just, you know, name your son Terrence or frickin' Dale or Jerry. Not Thoreau's. Okay. This next one. Oh, why do we do this? Why? This person's first name is No Fear. Your parents are in therapy. I'm just going to say it. This next one is kind of that Utah sort of name I was talking about. It's Kixley. This is, when I read this name, I didn't even have to ask. I know this person was born in a Utah hospital. Kixley. K-I-X-X-L-E-I-G-H. Kixley. Ugh. I kind of like the name Kix. What up, Kix? If I met a girl named Kixley, I'd be like, oh, cool, I'm calling you Kix. There's no chance of calling you Kixley. Okay, this next one. These sound like the name No Fear. It sounds like their last name is Fear, and they thought, oh, this would be clever, I'll name my son No, right? But no, the first name was No Fear. Same with the second one. Their first name is Irish Princess. You hate your kids, Irish Princess. This next one, I don't know why. My assumption is that this person is from, like, Nigeria or... they're either Nigerian or their parents... for sure we're at Woodstock. This person's first name is God's Power. God's Power. This next one is Phoenix, which is the name I've heard before. Don't hate it. Used to live in Phoenix, love Phoenix. But listen to how it's spelled. It is spelled F-Y-N-Y-X. Phoenix. That's how I would say it. If I saw that, I'd be like, oh, it's Phoenix. Or Fine IX. That's actually maybe a cool rap name, Fine IX. But if you need to name your son Phoenix and you just can't deal with the PH and you have to use an F, I get it, that's fine. Listen, there's the band Phoenix. It's fine, but just F-Y-N-Y-X? It's rude. This next name is also rude. Last name, George. First name, it's not curious. Last name, George. First name, George. I joked around earlier about a David. Here we've got a George. I would be so mad. Like, George is already like... I don't know how you name a baby George. Like, you'll see, like, a 68-year-old guy, and you'd be like, oh, that guy's probably named George. But how could you name a baby George? And if your last name is George, how could you look at that baby and say, I want double George. I want double George. I just don't get it. Okay, this next one is wild. This girl sent me this long message explaining everything. She said... this is her grandma, I believe. So her grandma, her name is Karma. Her birth name is Karma, which is a pretty cool name. I like it, especially with the K. Birth name was Karma. She changed it to Norma and didn't tell anyone until she was 88. And I don't know when she changed it. I assume it was like when she was a teenager or something. Maybe she didn't like the name Karma. Maybe Karma was just not where it was at in the 1940s. But I think Karma's way better than Norma. But anyway, she changed it. Didn't tell a soul until she was 88. It's like on her deathbed. She's like, fine, I'll tell you. My name's Karma. It seems so funny, like, to be weirdly, like, ashamed of your name. Like, if your name's Mo Lester, be ashamed. But, if your name's Karma, and you changed it to Norma, I don't get it. But here's where the story gets wild. Sweet Norma had herself 9 kids, which big ups to her and, you know, her uterus and all that were involved. But listen to the names of her 9 children. Okay? First we got Sunday. Then we got Monday. Okay? But mind you, Sunday is spelled S-U-N-D-I. Monday is spelled M-U-N-D-I. So we got Sunday, Monday. And you'd think maybe we'd have Tuesday, but we don't. We have Minel. M-I-N-N-E-L-L. Minel. Never heard that in my human life. Then we got Corey with a K. I felt like they got a little lazy there. Then we got... Oh, no. I see what they're doing. Okay, we got Sunday, Monday, Minel, Corey, Cherry. Or it might have been Sherry. C-H-E-R-I. Susie. S-U-Z-I. Honey. Honey. H-U-N-N-I. So... Everything feels super out of order. I don't know the order of the kids. I should have asked. But so far, you got your Sunday, Monday, Corey, Cherry, Susie, Honey. And then you got Manel thrown in there. And then you have John. But they couldn't just do John, a normal John. I don't know why they didn't do Johnny. That's disturbing to me. Susie, Honey, Johnny, that would have worked great. But no, they did John, J-J-O-N. That's J-J-O-N. J-John. And the last name is the worst of all. It's Ring. R-R-I-N-G. Ring. So all in all, sweet, sweet Norma, that was ashamed of Karma, went just out of her mind and named her kids Sunday, Monday, Manel, Corey, Cherry, Susie, Honey, John, Ring. Absolutely insane. This woman wins the award. She wins everything. She wins this episode. Norma, if you're out there, you win this episode. Okay, we're wrapping up. I got a handful more. Most of these I've ran into at work. Okay, so we got Hachu. Which, I don't know if that's Korean or what. I know Cho is a Korean name, so I don't know about Chu. Could be Chinese. But, Hachu, that's hilarious. Come on. again, a lot of these, with these foreign names, you give them a little bit more of a break. But, gosh, they're just funny. Okay, this next one is Dang Iran. I would, if that was my name, every time I wrote it, I would do a comma after dang. Dang, Iran. That's funny for like 12 reasons. This next one, this first name, her name was Queenie. Now, I've dated a Quinn. I know girls like to call each other Queen, but Queenie? It's really close to Weenie. And listen, after I've heard all these names, I'm starting to think just about every name out there exists. I bet there's a Weenie out there. I bet somebody's walking around named Weenie. Because there's a Queenie. The next one, surely a Utah name, Coastin. C-O-A-S-T-Y-N. Coastin. Just don't. This next one is pretty bad. I think. Yeah, yep. I asked somebody about this because this was a name I ran across at my work. And I asked somebody, hey, do you know so-and-so? And they said, oh, yeah, blah, blah, blah. And they told me this little story. So Their first name, I don't know if this is Vietnamese or what. Their first name is P-H-U-C. Last name Tran. So, Tran, right? If I saw that name, I would say Fuke. Puhuk. But somebody told me it's pronounced like the F word. So I'm going to spare you guys. Because for whatever reason, long ago, I decided I will never say the F word. And you know what? I haven't. I've never said the F word. I've said every other word that exists, but I've never said the F word. You gotta change that name. Because the person telling me this story told me that they, like, were talking to this person and they said, Fook. Do we have you on the line or whatever? And he's like, no, it's... And, you know, says the F word. So clearly, he's comfortable. I mean, maybe that's a power move. Like, no, my name is F. That's just crazy that you wouldn't change that. I would go by anything else. I would say, oh, no, my name is actually Horse Poop. You can just call me Horse Poop. Or, Pizza Salad. You can call me Pizza Salad. Any of those would be better than the F word. Next, this seems made up. But again, I'm trusting the system. This person's name is Real Savage. It's not clever. I mean, it's clever, but it's not good. Real Savage. This next one's a first name. I gotta assume it's a different ethnicity. It's Pornthrip. Pornthrip. P-O-R-N-T-H-I-P. Pornthrip. Yeah, just don't have the word porn in your name would be my advice. And the next one. This is the last one, actually. Their last name is Cole, C-U-L-L. First name, Mike. So their name is Michael. Their full name is Michael. Mike Cole. It just seems inconsiderate. Either a lot of these parents are trying way too hard to be cute, or they're idiots, or they're mean. I'm hoping some are just idiots. Like, they're like, oh yeah, let's name our son Michael. Michael would be just as funny instead of going by Mike. Michael Cole. But then, yeah, of course people are going to call him Mike, so it becomes Michael. That's crazy. That's almost, I'll tell you what's one of the worst I've ever heard after P-H-U-C. There was a guy I knew growing up. When I say guy, I mean a full-grown man. His last name was Hunt. His first name was Mike. Mike Hunt. Mike Hunt. Mike Hunt. I'm not going to say anything else. I'm just saying it's a funny name. And you know what? He followed my advice before I ever even gave my advice. He changed it. That was his real name, and he never told anybody. But I saw it in writing. I saw it on a document. But yeah, he changed his name. And I actually love this man. This is a great man. I'm not going to say his real first name in case... anybody knows who he is, but that's crazy, right? And granted, he was an older guy. He was, an adult male when I was in high school. And so when he was birthed, that probably wasn't something that crossed his parents' mind, having the last name Hunt. Hey, let's maybe avoid, Mike. Nobody told him. And I don't even know when that name became terrible for him. Maybe from the get-go, maybe it took a while. I don't know. I'll have to do some research. But anyway, those were our names, guys. I didn't know what, once I started reading these names, like at work, and it got my mind moving, and then I asked people for some more examples, and I got a bunch. I was like, this might be a weird, boring, dumb episode, but I have to do something with these names. I have to share them with the world. And if any of those people heard this and want to sue me for defamation, if you could do it publicly so I can get some more attention and some more notoriety, that'd be great. But I don't think that'll happen. So anyways, thanks for tuning in. If you enjoyed the podcast, feel free to, you know, tell a friend, tell a lover, tell somebody that you're, you know, you just started talking to. Say, hey, I got this new podcast. This chick had kids named Sunday and Monday and Corey and Cherry and Susie and Honey and Jijon and Raring and Manel. You know, let them know. Anyways, I appreciate you guys. I love you. And we'll see you soon for episode 41.